discuss opposing the nomination of the superintendent of the Nigeria country. So we have come here to get you the information on yesterday meeting with the protesters. So I will send that word to the media.
Thank you very much.
Also today you met those from the county citizens who are opposing Honorable Ellis Chester Green nomination as superintendent of the Nigeria country. What was the negotiation with the citizens?
Well, demonstration is a form of disagreement. That form of disagreement cannot be translated as an aggression. It should not be translated as an aggression. It's an expression of the citizens' refusal or disagreement with a confirmation or nomination of an individual from the county. And that's what we have been witnessing. The citizens here in Mongolia, in the United States, as well as Grand Jury County itself, have decided to say, to vote no to the nomination made by the president. And this is what is to be exercised today. And I went out there, and coincidentally, the nominee himself was here having meetings with me and trying to speak with me as to why he should be nominated, and he had to seek my support. And coincidentally, the incident outside was taking place, and I had to take him there so that the citizens will see that he's with me. We are not fighting. We are having discussion. And whatever it is, at the end of the day, all of us are going back to Grand Jury. Whether he's confirmed or not confirmed, we still belong to Grand Jury County. So the expression should not be translated into any form of aggression like it did last year.
Yes, Senator, the group of young people who are protesting are raising concerns about one, the divisive nature, allegedly, the divisive nature of the superintendent personally. They also talk about him being a fraudster, alleging that he's a fraudster on grounds that two universities expel him in this country. Those are genuine concerns. What are your thoughts on those?
Well, it is not a secret. When it comes to the issue of him not having a bachelor's degree, when he served as the representative in the lower house for 12 years, that information came out probably a year or two ago when he applied to the Columbia University of Graduate Studies, and it was revealed that he did not possess a bachelor's degree as he reported. And he admitted that actually he did not possess that degree when the university rejected him. And the Ibadan University, from which he had served and he earned his degree, also denied that he was ever there. So yes, that's a point against him. And the people that are demonstrating, they are students. These are people who are looking for role models. And as leaders who are now representing our county and our people, we at some point of time need to show that we are role models. And so the fact that he served within those years and only to find out that he did not earn that degree, I think there's a discontent that it has been under the illusion that he does have the degree. So, as academicians, they have the right to be angry. They have the right to be angry. And on the other hand, they also are saying that why is it that Grand Jury cannot have a person that has a degree to become superintendent? That is the assertion that they brought into my office here. Why is it that every time this government, any other government in the past, will always take somebody that does not have a degree? When we do have educated people, we have students in universities private universities and public universities that are graduating with these degrees. We have our uncles and our fathers who also have these degrees in the past and are in the professional field and all over that have the desire to serve the country. They have education, they have experiences. Why is it that this government is bypassing all these people and nominating people that don't have degrees? So at what point will a person who has a bachelor's degree or master's degree become a superintendent in that country to show to his or her parents that they too have a degree and would like to exercise their professional services to their citizens? So I think those rights are there, and I'd like to identify with them on those issues. And that's why we are saying to the president, the president has a law. The law is saying that the president has a right to appoint a superintendent to serve at his will and pleasure. But the president is an individual. So the will and pleasure of the president